change it. Although I see that it's all Greek audience, I make a presentation in English because I'm hoping to extend it beyond the Greek borders, because it has been, this issue has been until now very important, and it hasn't got the attention that I believe it should get. So in the title, first of all, the Greek malaise, why we chose the word? Because it's not a crisis. I mean, you can't have a crisis for so many years, so it's a malaise. The quick wins, unless we have some quick wins that really convince the people that something is happening, I see no hope in this effort. And systematic is also, everybody's talking about reforms, but my feeling is that they are not systematic. They are just little reforms here and there, and sometimes they create a bigger mess. So let's run through this thing. The problem is to establish for Greece trust and confidence of the Greek people towards their leaders. You all know why this trust and confidence has been lost, and you all know how difficult it is to establish it. You know that the voters stay at home. So my proposal is very, very basic, and it's to create just a single basic digital map of the whole public sector. And by that I mean just single numbers, like the license plates of the cars, that will be only the structures and the staffing, but that will allow us, this is a daily map, to compare two different periods. So it's very easy to do, it just needs one law, even smaller than the Diavia law, so it's just one page and you'll see it. And it's costless, and that's why I call it a touchstone. It's something that you can test whether someone is telling the truth or not. If they say we want to do reforms, they cannot start without having a basic plan. You cannot build a building without a surveying plan. You cannot actually radiate a tumor, a cancer tumor, without having, because our minister, you know, she's a medical doctor, without having made the scans. So it's absolutely mandatory to have an idea of what we are reforming. They are talking about evaluation. How can they evaluate something they don't know? And time matters, because people are dying. We don't see them, and we are in a privileged environment, but they are dying every day. So not all digital organograms, you have heard about this digital organogram that is happening, are the same. I consider them to be a very strong weapon against corruption as well, because you have a very clear view, and you can hang all the digital data if you have these IDs. And this is an idea of an air-powered gun. But this is also an air-powered gun, so you can call the same thing a very different thing. Very briefly, that's the idea that you can just give a number to each unit, and then you can very easily represent it in the computer with a table. But the thing is, there shouldn't be a solitary effort. Greece has a possibly lethal disease, and its governance refuses to face reality. And that's a major problem. And governance, I mean everyone. I mean the government, I mean the opposition, and I mean us, the people. It's very important that we, the people, reclaim what we should do. We are waiting for people that we feel that they can't do the job, and they say, oh, well, what can we do? They don't do it. Well, we already established that. So that's the problem stated. I'm not going to extensively run through it, but the Inspector General and the current minister have verified that there are units and people that we don't even know about. Something happened with... Yeah. That we don't even know about. So, they can't say that when you can see every single vessel, every single plane around the world, every single bus, in real time, all that. And here is what happened, all that was in 2016. And after these statements, here is the law of kinetikotita, the mobility law. That was the initial proposal that was in the consultation. And this is what was kept from the proposal. What is left out, always accurately and completely, freely accessible, unique digital ID, preserved as records, enforced and punished. What's left for that? Just a very simple thing to serve places for kinetikotita, for mobility. So it's very important to actually do a correct digital organogram, which is the one that proposed the Free Open Software Foundation in Greece. It was deposited in the parliament. Oops, something went wrong here. Well, here are steps that have been done, and there's a day counter on the right. We are in about 800 days since that proposal. Nothing happened. 1,000 days before, I had a very ambitious proposal, but then I realized that they don't really want to do it. So I said, what is the minimal thing that they can do? And this is just to give a number to each person and to each unit. And if they don't have a number, there cannot be any expenses for this thing. So they just say, if you don't have a number, you can't even buy paper for your printer. If you do have a number, near your number, I'm going to write 3 euros. And there are the cost centers that they are claiming now that they are going to do and finish in 2023. It's 5 years until 2023. And the problem is our expenses. The bucket, they are trying to fill a bucket that is leaking. I'm trying to stop the leaks. So that's my idea of how it should be. Instead of the lonely climber with the pitons, it should be people having fun, going all together in a team spirit. And that's us, the people, again. So this, what you see in the picture, I got it from the internet, obviously, which is a great resource. Was it planned? Of course it was planned. Where is the leader? You can't see him. He's in the crowd. And also, I would like to tell you about a seminar that I had some years ago, Inspiring Leadership Through Emotional Intelligence. It's a fellow countryman of us, Professor Boyazis, who is giving it through Coursera. I believe that now it has some cost, but he may even waive the cost for free. So several things in the newspapers. There are things that are being written, but they are not written so that they really make the change. So being in Delphi, I would like to refer to this Osozone Afton Sothito, which is very frequently misinterpreted as every man for himself. That's not the idea. The idea is if you want to save yourself, then you will save yourself, but you have to do something for it. And we are not. We are waiting for the others to come. We are waiting for people from abroad, consultants, etc., that have been here for so many years. And I can't understand how they haven't seen that this basic thing in the foundation is missing. One of the articles that you saw before was the void in the foundation, the vacuum. So reforms, it's a constraint-guided design problem. And of course, it must be carefully planned, and it's had the construction management issue. It's going from the present to the future, A to B, and of course the future must be better than A. If you have not mapped the present, how can you compare it with the future? And how can you prove that you have done reform? So the methodology is you set the targets, you map the present, and then you design the future. Our future mission is that we set the targets, but we're not mapping the present. So there is no way we can design properly the future. And there is no way we can evaluate what we have done. The administrative reform, for me, it's an investment. And it's the best investment that we can do for our country. You know that there are all these people that are coming, expertise funds, for example. It's a governmental agency in France. And still, they come here and they get paid to provide advice for us. We would be doing the same. We have been in this reform process since 2012. And the government could be getting money from it. They say always that the public sector cannot get money, cannot gain money. Yes, we can. But we should have the liberty to do it. So it's a matter of transparency. It's a matter of open data. It's a matter of civic engagement. What means civic engagement? What they have done in Canada, Trudeau Med. They say, okay, our prime minister promised so many things to do. What has started, what is in progress, what is achieved, what is broken. And it's the citizens that are doing that. So through the wisdom of crowds, which goes to a very good median, they achieve what they want to achieve. And then there is also more detailed things about each of those. This is the last slide. So it's that from this solitary effort, my hope would be that we'd be everyone together on the top, like a team. Now, if you allow me, there are two slides that are beyond this subject, but I believe that they are... Okay. Thank you, Mihaly. I believe they are very important for Greece, because what I'm claiming now is that we actually we are working on our own destruction. So if we eventually decide to save ourselves, then I believe that our fellow Europeans must help us protect our brand. I had said it last year in this forum again. It's the problem with GRECO. GRECO is this group of states against corruption, or Groupe d'État contre la corruption. GRECO is not an acronym, as you can see, because the acronyms would be GSAC or GECC or GECOCO or something like that. So they just chose the letters that they wanted, and they created GRECO, which they also logoed as a Greek flag, with the lines in between, which makes a direct association of corruption with Greece. I think this spoils our brand name like it was in the past with the Petit Larousse that was saying that Grec tricheur, etc., he was someone cheating in cards. And at that time, early in the 20th century, there was a movement and they changed that. I believe that we must change that. It exists since 1999, but that is not a reason for preserving something that is hurting our country. Thank you very much. That was beautiful.